Welcome to JSRST. Today we are going to see about a new operating system, Windows 10 AME. Windows 10 AME, it is not an official Microsoft launch of Windows 10. It is developed by a group of developers called the Ameliorated. So that is where the name comes from, Windows 10 AME. So let's check it out. What's so special about it? I'll tell it as the video goes on. So I am going to install this operating system in a virtual machine. So let's add a new virtual machine and name it AME, Windows, Microsoft Windows, and it's Windows 10. So let's select Windows 10, 64-bit. Next, and let's give it a lot of RAM because it's Windows. Okay, then next. Next, create and leave all the things as default. Dynamically allocated and since it's Windows, let's give a little more storage. I don't know if it will require that much of storage, but anyway, let's give it. I have a lot of free space on my computer. Okay, so the machine is created. Now go into the settings and check everything. Have a look at everything. Don't touch anything if you don't know what you are doing. Processor, it has given only one CPU. Let's give 3 CPUs, 3 cores, and then we'll go into storage. This is a very important step. You have to select the live image, AME 2004, that's it, nothing. If you want to share any folder, you can use the share folders. I don't want to do that. So let's go inside and let's start our virtual machine. And there we go, you see AME 2004, let me go into full screen. Okay, so the screen has booted up just like Windows. Okay, the installation screen has come on. Languages to install, let it be English, US. I don't have a problem with that. And then for time and currency, I am going with English, India. Where is India? GHI, English, India. Keyboard method will be English, India. Then click next and click install now. The setup is starting. Okay, on the screen activate Windows. You don't have to enter a product key, just click I don't have a product key. Okay, accept the license terms. Next, custom install Windows. Okay, what do you want? Where do you want? Just select the hard disk and next. And it's copying Windows files, getting files ready for installation. So, okay, what is Windows 10 AME? Windows 10 AME is a stripped down version of Windows. So, we all know that Windows 10 has a lot of trackers. It can track every move that we do in with our computers. And it has a lot of ads. When you open the start menu, you will see a lot of advertisements popping up, and that slows the computer a great deal. The computer is really slow when you run Windows 10. It takes more than 2 gigabytes of RAM. If you don't have any processors running, just the operating system will take more than 2 gigabytes of RAM. So that's not so good. So they have tried a new thing. This is maybe legal, maybe illegal. It's up to your moral conscience. If you want to use that, you can use it, or you may not use it. Who is this version of Windows targeted upon? This is targeted towards people who want to use Windows and they don't want the tracking, and they are not so keen on learning a new operating system. Like, they don't want to move to Linux. Moving to Linux would be a better option. It is legal. There are a lot of options for you to choose from, and you will not run into so many problems. Here it is just they have taken the source code of Windows and taken away all the telemetry, and that could result in unprecedented bugs. So we don't know what is in store for us, how the screen will boot up and all those things. Let's give it a try. If you are someone who wants to use Windows and still don't want to be tracked by Microsoft, then maybe this may be the chance to do it. Let's see. So the installation, just now it's got 6%, so I think it will take a lot of time. I'll pause the recording and I will come back when this step is over. So now the system is restarting. Press any key to boot from CD or DVD. No, we don't want to do that. We want to boot the system that has been installed. So don't press any key. That is very, very important. Yeah, if you do press the key when it says press any key to boot from CD or DVD, you will have to go through the installation process once again. So don't do that. And it looks like we are going to boot into Windows. Some weird thing just happened on the screen. Okay, the blue screen. Not the blue screen of death, but the blue screen, and username is user and password is multi. That's the default password. Welcome, and the login is askew, it's not in the middle of the screen. I think that is because I'm using a virtual machine and the resolution is not set correctly. Once we log inside, we'll look into that and make necessary changes. Yeah, we are there, but there is no taskbar, so I think the resolution is just too big. We'll go into display settings. And resolution. My screen resolution is not here. I'll have to settle for this one. So, okay, that means I'll have these two black bars on the side, but doesn't matter. I'm using a virtual machine. If you are using it on a real machine, you will not have this problem actually. This is just a virtual machine only problem. Okay, so let's close it and nothing looks different from here, just that there is no notification panel, I think. No, that notification panel, is it there? No, it's not there. That's a really good thing. It just has some useless stuff on there in regular Windows. Now let's go into the apps. See what apps are built in. The start menu is easy to start. Yes, now it started. Let's go into all programs. Firefox is the default browser instead of Microsoft Edge, and instead of Outlook, you have Mozilla Thunderbird. You have 7-Zip for extracting your zips and maintenance. Nothing there. Instead of Microsoft Office, you have only Office. And OpenShell. OpenShell has replaced the start menu. So what you are seeing here as the start menu is actually from OpenShell. Then Scoop Apps, Git GUI, Windows. There is a Windows terminal on command prompt. Startup. And we have VLC pre-installed. Calculator, Internet. Yeah, Internet Explorer is still there. Okay, but it is not present inside. So that's good. We don't need Internet Explorer, nobody needs that. Okay, Windows Accessories, Notepad, Paint is still there. Okay, let's open Paint. Oh, Paint has been in Windows for a really long time. It has been there even before I was born. Okay, so Paint is still there. And then, okay, Windows Accessories. Windows Media Player, but the Windows Media Player icon is not displayed properly, so I think Windows Media Player doesn't exist. Yes, nobody needs that too. I don't know why Microsoft ships it. And Windows Fax and Scan. Windows Fax and Scan. Okay. I don't know, I have not used this app. I don't think that sends any data back to Microsoft. And Windows administrative tools, there are a lot of them. Okay, Windows Ease of Access is there, Windows PowerShell is there. Yeah, command prompt is also there. So we have a terminal, we have a command prompt and a PowerShell. That's too many applications, but never mind. Apps, Snip and Stitch. Okay, so now let's go into settings and see what are the things that are gone from the settings. So in the home page, if you notice, we don't have the notification panel. Maybe it will come here, I don't know. Only if I get a notification, I will know that. And if you go into settings, you will see a lot more things have changed, I guess. Okay, where is settings? Apps. Settings. Oh, so that's very, very few options. We have like another 6 or 7 settings in Windows. We have accounts, we have Windows updates, we have Windows security, things like that. Here we have only system, devices, network and internet, personalization, apps, time and language, Safari. So everything that has telemetry attached to it has been removed. That's a good job. So remember that this is running on a virtual machine with just 3 cores of CPU and just around 6 gigabytes of RAM. So for that, this is a really good performance. So Firefox, have they done any modifications to this Firefox? Or is it the same Firefox that we get? And it's the first time, so I guess it will take some time to load. Okay, while that loads, let's check out some other things. What is there? Let's go into File Explorer. That opened really quickly. So, even for a virtual machine with just 3 CPUs, this is really quick than a regular version of Windows. Okay, so control panel, that's an important thing. Yeah, just plain old control panel. Okay, nothing much here for Microsoft to spy on you. Okay, but Mozilla Firefox is still not open, so let's close it and open it again. Okay, while Mozilla is loading, let's also fire up OnlyOffice. So Firefox is installing your update, so that's why it took some time. Okay, so Firefox boots up. Okay, it starts with pockets. So because of the resolution, it's really weird. Yeah, this is a modified version. They have added a couple of extensions. HTTPS everywhere, uBlock. That's good. So this is a very much a privacy-oriented operating system. It is completely opposite to the direction that Microsoft went after Windows 7. Okay, so Firefox is fine. Let's close it. OnlyOffice is the replacement of Microsoft Office. Yeah, there is an update. Okay, I'll install the updates. You can have OnlyOffice Cloud. You have OnlyOffice Cloud instead of OneDrive. You can have documentation, spreadsheet, presentation. That's all most people do. Nobody uses database in their home computer. I don't think so. I have not used it. Okay, ready to install. Let's install the updates. It's really quick actually for the limited amount of hardware that this operating system has access to. Okay, administrator password. I think it's multi. Same password, I guess. Yeah. Setup as detect only of is currently running. Okay. So preparing to install. That's good. So far so good. Just because I'm in a virtual machine, the resolution is not so good, but that should not be a problem in your real computer. Other than that, it's really good. Now most people actually use sticking to Windows because of the software compatibility. So let's try installing a .exe file. Maybe a few BitTorrent. Okay, let's search for the .exe file. Okay, in the background we have OnlyOffice downloading. So far so good. I will use it if I am not using Linux. If I want to use Windows, I will use it. So, but the company has had some legal troubles. They don't have an official website. These are all community maintained and they are released via torrent. So you will need an app like qubittorrent to download those torrents. qubittorrent is a really good app. If you are looking for an app for torrents, You can choose Cubic Torrent. Where is the download button? I don't think I'm in the right place since I'm using Linux and used to using the terminal. Now I don't know where to find the download button or the .exe file. Let's check this. Let's see. Yeah. So it's downloading from Cubic Torrent from the source forge, and here we go. Open the folder. What happened? Yes, there is some stutter. That's because of the limited hardware that the device has access to, but pretty good actually. If you run it on a real machine with some seriously good hardware, then I can assure you, you will get really good returns. Is there a task manager? So search. Yeah, this search is pretty good. I think it is better than the native search that comes with Windows 10. That's terrible. Okay, by the way, let's install this. So people may be thinking that yes, something we are installing in the background and installing another app here. So that's why you have to use. That's how you have to use a computer. Senselessly, it's your machine. You have to use it like that. Okay, the language. Yeah, it's unpacking. It's running. So if you are sticking with Windows, just so that you can be able, you will be able to download the exe file and just execute it, then I think this is more than enough. This is better than using the standard Windows 10. Okay, maintenance. Where is the Cubic Torrent? Okay, here it is. Next. I forgot a lot of things about how Windows works actually. I've just gone to Linux just 1 month and I forgot a lot of things. Okay, install. By the way, if you are looking for a better alternative than this, I strongly suggest you go to some distribution of Linux. So OneLibreOffice has finished updating, I guess. Cubic Torrent, this is the, so that's good. OneLibreOffice, we have notifications here. Do we have a notification tray? No. No notification tray. That can be a good thing, that can be a bad thing. I don't check notifications on Windows, I never did. So that will not bother me. Maybe it will bother you, so that's not a deal breaker. So everything looks pretty good. This is a really, really good work by the developers of Windows 10 AME. As I said, they don't have an official website. They have an official community maintained Telegram page called AME Releases. I will link it in the description of this video. You can download the torrent from there and download it by using the Cubic Torrent app or any other torrent app of your torrent downloader of your choice. So that's it for this video. If you want to know more about having to be tracked, you can check out my channel. I'll be posting a lot of videos about Linux distributions, how to use Linux, getting started with Linux, installing different distributions of Linux, things like that. If you are interested in stuff like that, you are welcome to check out my channel. Thank you. That's all for today. Have a nice day.